Jeg sidder her i en stol i det nordlige Uganda, i by kaldet Arua, på stolemarkedet, hvor de har nogle interessante stole. Man har gennem mange år lavet en speciel type stol, som er basis i den her skammel. Den er lavet med fire enkle ben og nogle tappe, som går op igennem benene. Det hele er spændt sammen ved hjælp af nogle palmestængler. Der er ikke brugt søm, skruer, lim eller noget, og alligevel er den stærk og solid. Vi skal på en lille køretur 10 km ud fra Arua på grænsen til Congo og se på en stolemager, som laver de her stole. Some different chairs from different areas of West Nile.
That's good.
And you told me that you recognize this chair. How do you recognize it?
Yes, I can recognize this chair here by the way how it is being made. This one is from our factory here.
Okay.
Yes, I can recognize it.
What?
Even you can see the way how it is being made.
Yeah.
Yes. And that other fellow is the one who made the chair.
Yeah.
He's also around here with me.
Okay.
Yes. These are the designs of our sons.
Okay.
Which we can normally, if we produce chairs, we put these designs
on you, so you can recognize that.
Yes, I can recognize.
So we never saw the process of putting the designs here, but here we can see how the designs are made here.
Yes.
And this is an old one, and you can see when it's has been used.
Yes.
It becomes shiny.
Yes.
Because of the grease of. From the hand, so in that way it's protected.
Yes.
Because you don't use any varnish or any coloring,
we don't
any
use
oil.
Yes.
So people just buy it like this.
Yes.
And then it becomes like this when time.
Yes, after time.
Has it been repaired? Can you see? Has this one been repaired?
No.
Is this the original tiles?
This is the original tile.
Yeah.
Yes. It's not that it's been repaired.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then we will see another chair. This chair is bought north of Arua, between Arua and Koboko. So it's a distance from here, like 25 kilometers.
Okay.
And it's the same principle being used for this chair, but there are some differences. The differences are in the timber.
Yes.
What kind of timber is this?
This is a
coconut tree.
Yeah, the branches.
Yeah, and you can see that it's kind of hollow. Is that a natural thing that it's hollow from the inside?
Yes, this is a natural hole.
Yeah,
of the tree. They use it for making their chairs.
Yeah.
Yeah. They don't use the eucalyptus trees like the one of ours.
Yeah.
Yes.
And how come the stem are so white? Have they done anything to it, or is it just the natural way?
It becomes very white because they wash it with sand.
With sand?
Yes.
Okay.
In the river.
Yeah.
They wash it with the sand, it becomes very 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 white like
that. Okay.
Even that one you can do the same way like this one.
Okay.
Yes.
And what about the tying here? What is used for tying here?
They use for tying sisal rope. This is sisal rope.
This is sisal rope.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
You sure it's not bark?
It looks a little to me it's bark, but it, you say it's sisal rope.
The sisal rope.
It's just the raw sisal ropes, you, as you told, we cut when it's green.
Yes.
Okay.
And it gets dry when we put it on the sun heat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And this one has a different design. You see the back is bent. Have you seen that before?
No.
You've never seen that before?
No.
Yeah. What do you think about this?
Now, the way of making this tea is very unique for the one of ours.
Yeah.
Because here they make it round.
Yeah.
They don't use this type.
No.
This is my mean for making it.
So this is the first time you see a chair like this?
Yes.
Even if it's only like 20 kilometers from here?
Yes, this is my first time to see it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How do you like this design?
This is very nice.
Yeah.
It's very nice. Yes.
And we don't know how they bent the timber. Can you see what it is? What kind it is?
I don't know this type of timber they use.
Yeah. Some of the stools are from you. This is from you. This is from you, and this one is from you. This is the kind of the original stool made many years ago, and that's the beginning of the chairs.
Yes.
This is the basic.
Yes, the basic.
The basic.
Yes.
And the main thing is we still have the legs in the same way and the tenon cut.
Yes.
And the shoulder here, and we have the frame.
Yes.
And we have these in between. And then the whole thing, keeping it together, keeping it tight, this is a kind of loose.
Yes.
But the thing keeping it together is the palm stem.
Yes.
That press this frame from each other.
Yes.
And keep it like
very
that.
Tight.
So it doesn't fall apart.
It doesn't bend, yes.
Yeah. And this has been there for like 50 years.
Yes.
So this chair has had its time.
But we don't produce this type.
No. But this is to show you that you can actually do things in a different way.
Yes.
If we continue to the other one, this one is from Pakwach.
Okay.
So it's a little further from Nebi.
Okay.
And you can see some similarities from this chair.
Yes.
We still have the groovings on this side.
Yes.
So they are tied to these two poles. And you have the back similar to yours.
Yes.
You have some sticks here, but then they have sticks going, three sticks going up this way, probably stopping at this point.
Okay.
But in Uganda, different places in Uganda, they're making, you can call them stick chairs in different ways. This one is from north of Kikumba.
Kikumba.
Yeah, on the way to Gulu.
Okay.
They make them in this way.
Okay.
And they don't yet use the same techniques as you do.
Okay.
They have like nails. They're nailing the whole thing together.
Mm.
And you see the construction is definitely not very good.
It's true.
Yeah. But they make them still.
But it looks very nice.
It looks nice. It looks nice and different.
Yes.
And this one over here is from Arua too. Well, what is the material for this? Do you know that?
This type of material is the same as with the one of that one there.
Okay, as the bending there.
Yes.
Okay.
They use the same material.
And this is found in the swamps?
It is found in the forest.
In the forest?
In the river valleys, yes.
Okay, yeah. So you're using eucalyptus?
Yes, this is the eucalyptus tree.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And where do you get that from?
We get it around in our place here, but a bit very far.
A bit far from here?
Yes.
So how do you foot that way?
We use our bicycles for bringing them home.
Okay.
Yes.
So you have a bozo?
Yes, we have a bozo.
A big one?
Yes.
Yeah.
For cutting them in sizes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So you cut them to sizes out there in the forest?
Yes.
And then you carry them like this?
Yes.
Okay. Mm. And you split it?
Yes, we split it.
You split it when it's still green? Still wet. I can feel that this is still wet.
Yeah. Yes, if it is wet, it is very easy to split it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Or maybe we can see how you split it. This is hardwood.
Yes, the wedge is hardwood.
Yeah. And the eucalyptus stone, it doesn't twist?
It doesn't twist.
Okay. Mm. Only a little, yeah.
Yes.
So he gets three pieces out of this.
Yes.
Yeah. Which one is the best? Which piece is the best?
Yeah.
The middle one.
The middle one is the best.
Yeah. So you use that for special purpose?
Yes.
Well, what do you use the middle one for?
Okay, we use the middle one for the place where you have to sit.
Because it needs to be strong.
Yes.
And the other ones goes for the armlin?
Yes, the armlin.
Okay.
And the back side also.
Yeah. So this is split into two?
Yes.
And this piece becomes the best?
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, we use this one for the part where you have to sit.
Okay. Yeah.
For the door side.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
The other one, we call it frame.
Yeah,
we use it
on the side.
On the side
of the chair. So this is the front one.
Yes.
This is the front one like this. Yeah.
Okay, the other one we put it here behind.
That's the this one which is good too.
Yes.
Okay.
We put it behind.
Yeah.
This is now the square of the chair.
Yeah.
Okay.
After this, we put another one for the armlin.
For the armlin.
Yes.
Yeah. And that's a smaller piece.
Yes. The smaller one.
Like the tinier one.
Yes.
Yeah.
You split it for the armlin.
Can we have a sample? Like there's one small piece there. Mm. So this one is for the armlin.
Yes.
Yeah. It'll be here.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like this.
Yeah.
Okay. Then another one also put it here.
Yeah.
Okay. After putting this, the small one you put it behind here.
Yeah.
For the real square.
Yeah.
After this, you fix the other one too for bending.
Yeah. Okay, these are the bags. Okay, so now he's going to clean the piece here.
Okay.
Yeah.
You start.
So this panker is sharp.
Very sharp.
Very sharp. And you don't cut yourself?
Normally we cut.
Yeah.
If the wind is too much,
okay,
it can bring the panga on your hand. You cut also.
Yeah. And he knows the size.
Yes, he knows the size.
Yeah. If you look at the side here, I can have this one. Which side is easy to handle? This side or that side? Which one is most difficult? I can say that like that.
We normally put this one up.
Yeah, okay, this one up.
Yes.
Okay. And this one is easy to cut.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes.
And this one is difficult to cut.
Yes.
Yeah. How long can the timber stay? Like from you go to the forest and cut it down and you bring it here?
Can take 1 week.
1 week.
Yes.
So after 1 week, it's too dry to work in.
Yes.
Yeah. So now it's almost ready now.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now ready.
So he leaves that.
Yes.
And continues with another piece.
Yes.
And leaves that one to another person.
Yes.
Okay. So it's fine now. Okay. So this is going to be. We need to have some holes there. So you need to show us how to
measure. So
this is the man. Use this stick
for measuring.
For measuring, and this is already prepared.
Yes.
So you take the full length. That's for the holes.
Yes.
Okay. And what are these other measurements? That's for.
Okay. This is making the holes for the frame for fixing other.
Okay. On the side here.
Yes.
For fixing the cross ones.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, we measure it here.
Yeah.
After measuring it, you give it for
this
for the holes, yes.
Then you can start drilling. And you said the holes here are 5 over 8?
Yes, this one is 5 over, we use the drill type 5 over 8.
Yeah. And he drills from down?
Yes,
up.
Yes.
Mm. But in the past, people were burning the holes.
Yes.
Yeah. So they had like a big piece of round metal.
Yes.
Heat it up and then burn the holes.
Yes.
But you don't use that technique anymore?
We don't use that one technique there.
Why?
It's a bit difficult for us. This one is the easiest way how we can make them.
Okay. Mm. And you make them precisely.
Yes.
Well, where did you get the tools from?
We bought this one from the market, Arua town.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. So now you're making a...
Now
like
we are making...
A gutter or a groove?
Yes.
Or not down here?
We are using this type of needle for making it.
Okay.
A hole here for
Do we have one which is already made?
It's here.
It's there. He has started making this one. Okay. Mm. So he's making a groove there.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So you're using the same stick again?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So this is an old hoe?
Yes.
Okay, he used that as a hammer?
Yes.
And what is this?
This is a center bolt of gascon. We use it for...
Okay, so you made it like a chisel?
Yes.
And you keep sharpening it?
Yes.
Yeah.
For making the groove.
Yeah. So the groove is for the palm stem,
yes.
For the seed.
Yes.
The seed rests in here.
Yes.
So this is how it looks when it's finished.
Yes.
So you don't put a straight line there. You just do it randomly.
Yes.
Yeah.
After this, you have to go and clean it.
Okay, let's see how we clean it. And then you put the piece in here, and it's stuck.
You start to clean it.
You clean it like that. It's now clean,
yes.
And you keep it away from the soil,
yes.
So it doesn't become dirty.
Yes.
You never smear it with anything.
No.
Okay. So this one is ready now for.
This one is ready for fixing it.
Okay.
For making the square with the tear.
And the same thing with the other pieces. Maybe we'll have a look at the legs. How you make the legs? Could you do that?
Yes. By using panga knife.
Yeah.
After cleaning it, you measure the size of the leg.
Yeah.
After making the size. You make the other part,
yeah,
to be sharpened. After making it, you measure the size of the leg,
yeah,
how it could be. After making the size, you have to use this type of saw.
This is a bow saw.
This is a bow saw. It is
locally made.
Yes.
Yeah. And it's sharp still.
Yes.
Yeah.
We use it for cutting it,
yeah.
For the size.
Yeah.
Yes.
And then you clean it afterwards, so this has a shoulder.
Yes.
For the other pieces to rest on.
Yes.
Okay. I can see that you have, actually, you have a bevel on that side.
Yes.
So you are sharpening from this side.
Yes.
And this one is just plain.
Yes.
Because then you get the best cut.
Yes.
When you are right-handed.
Yes.
If you were left-handed.
Okay,
then you will do it opposite. Exactly. I can see that. So even this one goes up in the hole to be cleaned.
Yes.
Yeah. So now it's ready for cutting the shoulder. Yeah. And how do you measure that? You do it by finger?
By fingers, yes.
Okay. What kind of timber do you use for the bow there?
This is a hard timber.
Yeah.
We get them in the forest.
Okay.
Yeah.
Those are the one hangings from the trees?
Yes.
Okay. So they stay strong?
Yes, they stay strong.
Yeah. You have them in big size too?
Yes.
And you use this kind of bow saw when you go to the forest to cut?
We use the other bow saw for going to cut the logs in the other side.
Yeah.
The big size.
The big size. Okay, so now he is ready to... He has made the cuts for the shoulder, and then he's cleaning. You're cleaning this way.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so he's cleaning in that way. Okay.
Yes.
How many do you have of those?
This type of knife?
Yeah.
We have here them five.
Five of them.
Yes.
And they're all the same?
They're all the same, yes.
Yeah. I can see they're made in Austria.
Yes, they're made from Austria.
Yeah. So he knows the size, he can feel it.
Yes.
He doesn't need to measure, but it needs to go down here. And it fits now.
Yes.
And you fix it in a way that you, the last part you knock down.
Knock it, yes.
Yes. Okay. Here we have all the pieces for the chair.
Chair, yes.
So this is the front.
The front pipe.
And you have another one with a...
This one is the frame, the side one.
The side one?
Yes. You put it this way.
Okay, down?
Yes.
Yeah, down this one. And there's a back. Is this the back?
It's this one here.
This one there, okay.
Yes.
And then we have the legs, and then we have some thing for the...
Okay. Let this one be here.
Okay.
Other one there.
Okay, so this is the front of the chair. It's going this way.
Yes.
Going this way.
Yes.
Okay.
Now this one is amlin.
This is amlin.
Yes.
Okay. And this one is to support the amlins from the back.
Yes.
And then we have the back is coming up this way. Okay, like that.
Yes.
So it'll be this one is going through and into this one.
Yes.
Okay. So this is made quite tight. You can do it.
Yes.
Yeah. And he's using the panga and making marks there. It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
Okay. Mm. But the tendon is kind of oversized, so it's stuck there.
Yes.
Yeah.
If it is very loose, it cannot do it alone.
Yeah. Does it crack sometimes?
Cracks?
Yeah. If it's too big here.
If it is too big, it can make a crack here.
Yeah. Mm. So he's adjusting it now.
Yes.
Yeah.
Miss Raka.
Oh, you still need to... Okay, to make it a little bigger, the hole a little bigger.
There might be a slope somewhere.
Okay.
We want to make it very straight.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Now this is the other side.
Yeah?
Mm.
So he's adjusting it now so it's straight?
Yes.
Yeah? So this is one side.
Yes.
And then he's fixing the other side?
The other side, yes. Yeah.
When you go to the market, can you recognize your chairs, the chairs coming from this workshop?
We normally know the way how we make it.
And you put some designs on,
yes.
Burning designs.
Yes.
Yes. And you have your special way of doing it.
Yes.
And then you can recognize it.
Yes.
Yes. So this is the other frame.
Yes.
How long does it make, like, to go through the whole process to make a chair? How long does it take?
It can take something about 3 hours.
3 hours.
Yes.
From you begin.
From
taking, splitting the lock,
yes.
Until you can sit in the chair.
Yes, it can
okay.
Take 3 hours.
Yeah. But you have divided the process, so some people are specialized and do the same thing.
Yes.
Yeah. So he is always sitting there, assembling the chairs.
Yes.
Yeah.
is now the sitting place.
This is the front?
Yes.
Yeah.
That one is the back one.
Yeah.
Now he's using this one for fixing it.
Yeah. So it needs more heavy weight.
Yes.
Yeah.
This is now the square of the chair.
Yeah. Mm. And it's fine.
Now, he's tapping this one for fixing the amling.
The amling.
Yes.
But you don't make any shoulders there.
What?
You don't make shoulders?
No.
On this one. So they just go in there and you hope that they will stay?
We don't make it like that.
Okay. Mm. But you don't put a nail this way?
Nailing?
Yeah.
You nail it when the work is over.
Yeah. Okay. But this size is smaller than, that, so this hole is different from?
The lower one.
Yeah.
Yes.
The lower one is
because
how much?
The drills, we have two types of drills here.
Yeah.
This one is a big size,
yeah.
This one should be small one.
Yeah, so the big size is like 22 or how much?
The big size.
The big size is, it's almost 1 inch. I think it's 1 inch, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. You can measure. My thumb is exactly 1 inch. You see that?
1 inch.
1 inch.
Okay.
God, he made the man with 1 inch thumbs.
Okay.
Yeah.
But man cannot reach 1 inch.
Yours?
Yes.
Ah, it's close.
Yours is a bigger.
Then you go down there.
Yeah.
So he's putting on the armlings now.
Yes.
That's the next.
Yes.
And is there a special way? When you have the grains, you look at it how, or is it random if it's like this or like that?
No.
It should be like that.
It should be like this.
Yes.
Mm.
Then you cut this one afterwards?
You will cut it afterwards, yes.
Okay, so you knock it down so it's
a bit tight.
A bit tight. You don't use any glue?
We don't use any glue.
No.
So it's like
very
this.
Very strong at this time.
Yes. So after this.
These ones into
this,
size.
This small poles, yes.
Yeah.
For fixing them here.
Yeah, that's for the seed to rest on.
Yes.
Yeah. And that's what he's doing now.
Yes.
So you need to do that individually. So when you have the. You cannot do that before. You need to do that.
Okay.
Yeah. So he's measuring like that?
Yes.
So now he has that one there. Then he makes three of them.
Yes.
So then he will sharpen them so they fit into the holes.
Yes.
Yes.
Because he has known the size of the drill.
Yeah.
Yes.
But how does he fix them when?
Fixing them, we need to remove these things out.
So he removes them again?
Yes.
Okay. So even if he has assembled, he removes the things
for fixing this.
For fixing, yes. Because but he needed the to assemble it to measure the right length.
Yes.
Yeah. So he will dismantle it completely.
He will remove this upper side.
The upper sides. Okay.
Yes.
So this one is going to take to hold the. That's why he's removing more bark because it's holding the back. Okay. Yeah. He's cutting off the.
Now he's removing it for fixing
these sticks. Yes.
Leave this one like this.
Okay. Okay. Only to make it a little loose.
Okay, you put it here.
There's something to read.
It's now tight.
It's very tight.
Yes.
And what about these ones here?
No.
In the back?
They are coming.
They are coming.
Yes.
So now you can almost sit on it.
Yeah. Now you measure this one.
It's making the upper one.
Yes.
Okay. And it has the groove there too.
Yes, it is a groove also.
Yeah, so it's going to be fixed this way.
Yes.
And then it leaves room for the seed to come up this way.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, you measure.
So he's not cutting from up.
Yes.
He's only cutting on three sides.
Yes.
Yes.
Design.
So now it's there. You don't use knives, you don't have small knives.
For that one, we don't use knives.
Okay.
We use panga knife.
Okay, only panga knife, you don't have small knives.
No.
No. So these ones are going to be the in-between sticks
further
up there.
Yes.
So there's one upper.
Yes.
Up. Okay.
You make it very strong.
Yeah. And how do you... Okay. Yeah.
We are still fixing poles here. This one will be here.
It will be there. Oh, there. In there. Okay. Okay. Mm. And then you will have an upper one there.
Yes.
And you will have one,
yes,
two, three this way.
Yes.
So he's making the three now.
Yes.
And he needs to fit them exactly so they fit on this chair here.
Yes.
That's why he's making it now, and you cannot do it in, you cannot do it before.
Yes.
He needs to do it in the process here.
Yes. Yeah.
And how many chairs do you produce a day here?
A day?
Yeah.
We produce about 15 or 25.
Okay.
Daily.
Daily.
Yes.
So every day you bring all these chairs into Arua?
Yes.
Yeah. And they are sold every day?
They are sold, yes.
So And even the other workshops bring in that amount?
Yes.
And what about Sudan?
Sudan, the people who take them to Sudan, they buy it from us.
Yeah. So okay. they come here with a vehicle?
Yes, they come with a vehicle.
Yeah, and bring them
buy
to Sudan.
And go with them to Sudan.
Yeah.
Yes.
And what is your price for one share like this, when it leaves your workshop? Not from the market at Arua. But when it leaves the workshop here.
If the person buy it from us.
Yeah. Like the people going to Sudan?
We give one like this, 2,500.
2,500?
Yes. And if he's taking many.
Yeah.
2,500. Then if the person is taking one,
yeah,
you will give it 3,000 shillings.
3,000 shillings.
Yes.
And in Danish, it's around 10 kroner. Or if it's in dollars, it's around $2.
Yes.
Yes. So now he's ready with those sticks. This one needs to be shorter.
Yes. Now he's going to fix them now.
And when you buy, no, we're talking about the price. You sell, if you only sell one, it's 3,000. If you sell it at the market, how much is the price then?
At the market, normally we sell them the same price.
The same price, okay.
Yes. Yeah. Now, this is now complete.
This is now complete.
It's now remaining there.
The seeding.
Yes.
Now he's cutting into size.
He's now cutting in this part out because we need the other size to be very small.
Yeah.
You cut here. Okay. You cut this one.
So you use your fingers there. It should be three fingers.
Yes.
Okay.
But I don't need it.
You can use my fingers.
Yes.
But this is three fingers and a little more.
You can put three or four.
Okay.
Yes. We measure it by using our four fingers. But do this.
Yeah, yeah, four fingers.
For measuring the size.
Okay.
The back one, we put three.
The back one, you put three.
Yes.
Yeah.
The front one, we put four.
And now, the downer ones are not cut.
Now the downer ones are now okay.
Yeah.
It's now remaining to fix the palm seeds.
Yeah.
Yeah. We are going to clean the palm seat to be fixed here.
So this is a palm.
Yeah.
So it has been long.
Yes.
Like this.
Yes.
With some leaves.
Yes.
On the side.
Yeah.
And then you have removed the leaves.
Yeah.
And it's strong.
It's very strong.
Very strong.
Okay. You first cut this.
Down.
Okay. You clean it.
So you split it?
Yes, you split it into two.
Into two pieces?
Yes.
Okay. So he cleans it first?
Yeah.
So that's where all the leaves have been...
Yes.
And where do you get these palm leaves from?
We got them from Congo.
From Congo?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So there are plenty?
There are plenty.
Yeah. You go there yourself or you buy them?
They bring them in the market.
They bring them in the market?
Yes.
Only for this purpose?
Yes.
Yeah. So now he's going to split it?
Yes.
So it splits easily?
Yes.
Yeah. And this part is not being used?
No, we use this one also.
You use this one also?
Yeah.
So he cleans that one?
Yes.
Split it again?
Yes.
Okay. So out of one you get three pieces?
One becomes three.
Yeah. And then he cut off the middle part, he cuts off the triangle so it becomes more flat.
Yes.
Yeah. When you make a chair like this, how long will it last? We have in town seen some chairs who are broken. How long time is the warranty for the chair?
If you keep it proper, it can last for 10 years.
For 10 years?
Yes. Yeah. It can last for 10 years.
But you don't give the warranty for that?
If you don't keep it proper, it can last for 4 years.
Yeah.
It depends how we use it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Phase 2.
Now you can come with this palm seeds.
So they're ready now?
They're now
they're ready to be put
on. We're going to fix them here.
So he fixed them down first?
Yes.
And let them rest on the on these sticks?
Yes.
So he breaks it with a finger?
Yes.
Like that?
Yes.
And he has the downer part of the palm stem is down?
Yes.
So it's wider down?
Yes.
And more narrow up?
Yes.
Okay, so it can be wider this way and more narrow that way?
Yes.
Okay. And they're stuck there?
Yes.
But then you need to fix them with the
rope.
With rope?
Yes.
Yeah, so you tie them afterwards?
Yes.
This is the okay, and you split it?
Yes.
Yeah, he's splitting it. So where do you get the rope from?
We buy them.
You buy them, so
from
you
the
you
market.
Pay. Okay.
Yes.
And it's not expensive.
It's a bit expensive.
But still, you prefer that instead of using.
Because people admire it.
Okay.
Yes. This is how it's now tied.
Okay, so there's one going along which the other one is tied to.
Yes.
Okay. So you go over two and back. Over two and back to one. And then a knot. So then again you go over two around the stick behind and tie it. So he is extending now?
Yes, extending the rope.
Yeah. So what kind of knot does he make that? How do you make the knot for the extension? Let me have a look at that.
For the extension?
Yeah. So you bend this one round.
Mm-hmm.
And you change this one like this.
Okay.
Then it goes down here.
Okay.
And into this loop there.
Okay.
And you just hold it.
Now okay.
Now it's okay. It's good when you make chair seatings.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
To tie it like that.
Now we are going to tie to this one. This two.
Yeah.
Yeah. With the rope.
Yeah. Mm. So you just tie it. Now the tying is finished.
Yes.
And the chair is almost done.
Only to cut this proper.
Okay. Proper. So that's what he's doing now.
Yes. Using this small bosso.
Okay.
For cutting it. Yeah.
So now it's ready.
The chair is now ready. Yes.
I can try.
Yes, you can try it.
Let me try. Maybe I'm too big. Ah, it's nice.
It's nice.
It's nice.
Only that for yourself should be expanded here.
You think so? You think I'm too fat?
Yes.
You think I'm too fat? Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you too.
Oh,